Welcome to the Bullhorn. Howard Lindzen off in Paris, tweeting or eating baguette, whatever he may be doing. So we're fortunate to have Josh Brown, the reform broker, in subbing for Howard. How's it going?
Thanks for having
me. Let's get right down to it. As they might say in France, let them eat cake. Eat and cake.
Sure.
Two ticker symbols for very hot restaurant stocks. What's going on in that sector, casual dining?
I think these stocks at the beginning of the year were kind of priced for some kind of scenario where nobody ever goes out to dinner again.
Right.
They are all at 52-week highs. This is feeds into that theme of things that people can't afford to do for themselves.
Yes.
Right. They're also not that much more money than feeding a family of four at home. To go to an Applebee's or a Darden group franchise.
Right, Red Lobster, Olive Garden, exactly.
These things are doable. People are coming out of their shells. The stocks are telling you the story.
All right. Another area people may be coming out of the bunkers, the auto business. Obviously, there's
sure.
a certain Detroit company that went public a few weeks ago that we're all aware about. But auto parts retailers, I mean, you've been talking about AutoZone is possibly like a best-in-breed stock, if you will.
Well, yeah, I mean, there's a couple things going on. You got to separate the auto parts group in two. You take the companies that are actually making auto parts and selling them to companies like GM, which is back from the dead,
right.
and Ford, which is actually resurgent. Then you've got the other side. You've got the retailers that are catering to a consumer that's keeping a car on the road longer than almost ever before. So you've got people going into the Pep Boys, going into the auto zones,
right.
and they're looking to kind of extend the life of the car they have before they go out to the dealership. The sector is blazing, up 43% in the last 3 months.
Unbelievable.
Up like 70% year to date. Very few sectors even come close.
Let's move on. Another hot stock, somewhat amazingly, Coinstar.
Right.
No one obviously is interested in that particular business, the Coinstar name business, but they own Redbox, and Redbox has continued to do extremely well, even though we're in a world where, up until recently, Wall Street had been so infatuated with Netflix. Now it seems Coinstar is the hot momentum stock in that area.
Coinstar has something that people want. It's a dollar. You show up, you get your movie, you don't deal with any human beings, which we're all sick of doing, I guess. You interact with a machine, and you return at your own leisure, and it's working. People are flipping out for this service, and I'm using it myself. The kids love it, and the stock is, again, telling you the story.
Right.
This is a hot thing.
All right, this brings us to our final point, as the Lone Ranger was fond of saying, "Hi-yo, silver away." The metal has been on fire, 30-year highs. Is there legitimate industrial demand driving up some of the silver mining stocks and the metal itself, or is this just a derivative on the gold bug play?
Yeah, you cannot chalk up the moves that these silver stocks have made toward some sudden increase in industrial use. This is really about the weak dollar. It's a derivative of the gold play, and there are really only a handful of ways to get silver exposure. It's not that wide a market like gold, so it's just become a mania as people grab these same five or six stocks and ETFs.
Right. And that usually does not end well for the average investor.
You know, we've been in these silver names for, I don't know, a year and a half now. The people that are coming in at these levels, silver at $30, some of these stocks have added billions in market cap very quickly. The people coming in here are coming in very late in the game,
right.
and I'm starting to get nervous looking at what these stocks have done.
Gotcha. Good advice. Like with any asset that has really enjoyed a spectacular run, you have to be somewhat skeptical.
Sure.
So that's a good point to wrap up. I know you said in your Coinstar bit that we don't like dealing with human beings, but I'm happy to deal with you, and we will do this again on Friday since Howard remains in France.
Thanks, Cole.
Thank
See you next
you.
Time.